Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the Super Producer series. We're going to focus on Teddy Riley. He's one of my favorite producers of all time. He's behind the New Jack Swing sound that sounds like this. And we'll get into like what this is, but it's an incredible genre. I'm so thankful that he created this genre. I fell in love with it when I was playing Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. Shout out to all my GTA fans out there. I was playing San Andreas and on CSR radio, they would play all these New Jack Swing songs. And San Andreas was modeled after the 90s. So I didn't even know those songs were out when I was coming up. Like I used to listen to jazz when I was a little kid. And anyway, long story short is that New Jack Swing is like this really unique genre. It lets you be musical, but it's also dancey at the same time. And I think that's why it's so good. It's because it's musical and it's dancey. And it's very fun sounding, very happy, jovial type of sound. It's just super unique. Teddy Riley's just incredible for the style and everybody else who helped out with the groups and everything else. There's a documentary on Tidal. If you want to learn more about him specifically, I highly suggest it. It got me super motivated. And these drums are from the Akai MPC 60 and the Akai XR10. And that's where you get these drums. That's like the New Jack Swing go-to snare. Then I have a little subtle clap. Crash, very subtle. You can pick any kick, really. Just don't like be too modern with your trap kicks, because this genre is very about like sound selection. So when you use the samples he used, you will probably get the sound he has instead of using trap drums all the time. Then you have an XR10 tambourine. And then I have a reversed open hi-hat that I mangled, used the whole parameter on. So I did the drums first to save you time. Also, the swing parameter is near 50%. That's why it's called New Jack Swing, okay? Because that swing parameter is almost all the way cranked. And it's just really a loop with a couple interesting things going on. So I grouped the drums so that I could prevent them from clipping. Okay, so now let's work on adding synthesizers. So really it's about your improv skills here. I'm going to play the chord Kronos and I have a nice synth pulled up. And what I'm going to do is loop this for a good, let's see, like however many bars this is. And I'm going to play synth lines over the track. Then I'm going to do the bass. So it's synth and then the bass. You could try bass first, but you might get locked in. So let's record audio into playlists. Let me do that take again, mainly because I was like trying to think of what I played before. Dun, 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 dun. And then notice what I'm doing with the notes. I'll start going upward up the scale. That's a trick that Teddy uses a lot. And I'm using pitch wheel a lot. A lot of pitch bending, a lot of like. So listen in for that. I gotta do it again because I was trying to think and I didn't play it out before, so give me a second. So let's try that. Okay, exactly what I was trying to play, but it's close enough. We just need a bass line, meaning like a bass, B-A-S-E line, like a bass. So I'm not sure why it's monitoring twice. I probably forgot to unmute the console. So if you're hearing like a double thing, that's probably why. I think I forgot to mute the console. We can get rid of the other takes. Save space. So let's move to the Moog. And I have a funk bass loaded up. So boom, boom, tick, tick, boom, boom. I don't even know what I'm gonna play, but it starts at C sharp, I know that much. So the hard part is going to be trying to play it as fast as I need to play it, because it needs to start right off, boom, 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 boom. So it's going to be off a little bit, so I might give myself like, maybe 4 bars. Let's slide this over so that I can prepare to get in position, and then I'll do it. That way it will line up. Best to do as many different tries as possible. So you can see the bass is probably the hardest part, because you have to play really fast and in rhythm. And the thing is, I'm hearing a small delay, so that was throwing me off a little bit. So hopefully the timing matches up. So I might be playing earlier, because to me I'm hearing it a little late. So let's slide this over a little bit to the right. The shift right. Here it's a little early. So I didn't get it right until probably the very, very end. So let's just keep cloning this over until it makes sense. So let's slide. Let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4. Da da da. At the end, I don't know. I don't think it should start right there. Yeah, it's still early, so we're going to slide that manually to the right. Again, highlight it. Hit shift right, change the snap to grid to none. It's different than hitting alt right. Alt right does it at a certain increment. Shift right can do it at smaller increments. So it's hard getting the timing perfect, so let's just pull it down a little bit. We'll be right back. This would be good enough. Before I fixed it. I didn't mean to do that. Take it off time stretch. I think I started getting it right around here. So you can see how fast the bass is moving super, super fast. So that's a key element. Make sure your bass, if you're going to play it by hand, make sure it plays really fast. Let's see how many bars we have. We have 12 bars. Good enough. Let's go back. Now it's misaligned here. Let's figure that out. And it must not have been. Anyway, use your slip tool, hit Alt, drag it over. In R&B, all you need is 12 bars. Usually, it's not like hip-hop where you need 16. Close enough. Okay, I'm no Teddy Riley. Now, I would go back and add little bass lines, like little... let me show you what I mean. We're going to have to mute the original bass, go back to the Moog, and then play like little riffs in between, little fancy stuff. So let's try that. It would take up too much time trying to come up with little phrases, but that's the trick. And then you just slice them out and then replace it wherever you want. So for example, the end sounded kind of cool. So I didn't really hit the notes right, but it should be dun 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 dun. But that could be a different ending for you, just as an idea. And then you can replace that every four. So you would zoom in, grab your slice tool, hit shift, left click, slice that out. And didn't mean to do that. And then you would just move that around a bar at a time and just swap it out for something like every four things. So for example, go to bar mode. You can move it over here. So that will be a better ending. And then you slice out whatever's there. So you would just zoom in. Just throw in that little change up. So you splice them together, make it one thing. Let me add a clipper to the thing. The thing and the thing and the dude. Let's find more synths on the chord Kronos. Pretty sure there's more sounds we could add. Now notice we don't have any chords yet. Add some more synths in here. So now we're just going to stack synths, staying in the key. It's really the trick. And what else do we have? So let me go through synths, see if we can find anything. We want like a brassy synth and something that we can pitch bend. So Trevor's going to guide the ear through the scale, starting at, what was it, C sharp, I think, chord. We're gonna keep that synth way in the background just for like atmospheric tonal texture, because it was like a layer. I didn't notice it was a layer until like halfway through. So it sounds like a vocal. It goes from like a string to a vocal. Let me just go towards the end. See what else we can find on the chord chronos for sound. These atmospheric synths in the background just kind of creating a tone, starting in C sharp. Thank you. So just ear candy in the background, nothing too major. Just to keep the track moving so it doesn't get stale. You can pan stuff left and right so you can differentiate between the synths. But don't make them too distracting. I don't think we need anything else except vocals on this, which I'm not gonna sing. Took me a while to come up with the chords because I'm not used to this key. So let's try that chord out. It's a simple triad, then it moves into but I'm flicking through like the seventh to ninth version of it, and then I'm coming back down to a seventh. That's what I'm doing. So, simple chords, nothing too complicated. We're gonna tuck them in the back so it doesn't throw off the rhythm. We're pretty much done, you just need vocals at this point. Maybe like a change up. One more thing you could add is like a vocal, like, up, up, oh yeah, if I could find it.
Yeah, what? You, that's right.
Yeah.
I'll just record it myself and act like I sampled, which we are sampling technically. Oh yeah, and then I'm gonna run it through like a filter and you'll see. All right, let's try it. So that's how you do it. And then we're going to run it through a filter. Give me one moment. Check, check, check. There we go. Let's run this vocal through track 11. Mixer channel 11. Let's run it through an EQ. And cut out the low end and boost the mids so it sounds like it's coming through a radio. Now, if you want to get real kind of old school about it, you can have a phase shift. You can use Fruity Stereo Enhancer. Just pull the phase offset. This may or may not sound good. Let's try it. Needs a little bit more filter. Filter out the highs. Cut out the highs. Tighten up the curves. Thank you. That last one kind of got out of control. I wonder why it was louder. But anyway, had a lot of fun. Teddy Riley, thank you. What I learned from Teddy Riley, let me know which super producer or any producer you want to study next. I'm willing to listen to a lot of new people or older producers, whatever. Just leave it in the comments below who you want to see next. Thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.